offensively, this has been a tough day for them. Trying to find a place to throw the football, it's been extremely difficult. I've got to give a lot of credit to the secondary, especially the corners who've had the receivers on lockdown.
Now Darnold going to take it and just bat this one forward to his wideout.
And he is out of bounds inside the 35. 13 yards, first down, Panthers.
Just a simple tap pass, but it pays off in a big way.
And sometimes the simple stuff causes the most problems for a defense because there's a breakdown in communication there. When that receiver goes behind the line of scrimmage and it looks like he's going in motion, someone either has to go with him or he has to be passed off to another defender. Somehow, they didn't get that communicated well, and it turned into a nice play.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now, I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here,
and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes.
And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first timeout. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the two-minute warning. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long.
A fake to McCaffrey. Now Darnold.
Eluding the pressure right. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. They'll put it down right at the 40, so call this a 50-yard attempt. Gonzalez's kick is good. And the lead becomes four now, 14-10. So they get the three, but you wonder now, is that going to be enough?
Excellent question, because when I look at the smiles on that side of the field, they're a little tight, aren't they? If they had scored a touchdown there, those would be big half-moon grins right now because they'd feel a whole lot better about their position.
And a touchdown in the other direction. All of a sudden, they're down.
And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line.
Jackson and the Ravens, here they come. Down 14-10, 2:11 to go. They'll have two timeouts and, of course, also the two-minute warning as they go to work on first down. They'll run with Edwards here to begin the drive. And he'll power his way forward for about 4 yards there on the first down carry. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Raven football here as we welcome you back. They come up on a second down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down to the wire. They'll roll him out right. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. It's a big play there for Baltimore.
We see this happen so often. If you're a defender, it's like watching a bad movie over and over. The pressure's good, forcing the quarterback out of the pocket. But it's a lot to ask for these defenders to stay plastered to receivers long enough. And sure enough, they let a man come open, and the connection leads to a big play.
Stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of 5.
I like the call there because that was one to take time off the clock and get them closer to getting out of here with a W. In the mind of the play caller, all you want to hear is tick, tick, tick.
The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. Throwing, Jackson. Flush to his right. And he is out of bounds right around the 10-yard line. Late in the game, defense trying to avoid a big play. He's able to work out of the passing game, turn it into a run, pick up the first, and stop the clock as well.
And you know in this situation, everything is sped up. The intensity, the thinking, everyone's movement. But for a quarterback, he has to continue to be what we call a flatliner. Level in everything he does and read the clock, feel it in the pocket, and go at the appropriate time.
Edwards now on 1st and 10. And he'll fight his way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be 2nd down.
When we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place.
But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
That'll be a pickup of four as they work with this four-point fourth quarter lead. They come out with one back and three tight ends. Jackson steps away. And that is incomplete. This pass rush, they've been excellent all game long, and another example of it right there in the closing moment.
Not only with the pass rush, but how well they're coached, because if you don't quite get there, get to the quarterback, get your hands up into the passing lane, and knock it away, as we just saw there.
Here we go. It's Jackson on fourth down, escaping the pressure right. And this is caught. Touchdown. And they've taken the lead here in the final minute.
How many people watching this one right here gave up? Because that score, they might want to try and rush back into this stadium.
Yeah, what looks like is going to be the game-deciding score, although a little bit of time left, so you can't count your chickens before they're hatched.
Well, they better come back in here and watch this one, because you and I, we're not going anywhere. We want to see this one play out.
Tucker with the extra point. So it's now a three-point game here in the closing stages, as a field goal now can only tie it. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. And now it's the Panthers' turn, trailing by a field goal. 26 seconds to go. They need at minimum 3 points out of this as they come up first and 10. Darnold. He's going to let it fly. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. Following the incomplete pass, here they go again. Second and 10 from the 25. Now Darnold. Flushed out right. This is Anderson. And he's going to pick up a first down here as that clock continues to run. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as he'll stop it with 13 seconds left to play. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Darnold to throw. Thomas has got it. Complete. And with inside of 10 seconds, 8 to be precise, we get whistles and a timeout on the field. Here's Darnold. There again is Thomas. They've gone to him a lot. And they will get the timeout. So 3 seconds remaining, and they can trot out the field goal unit and try to send this one to overtime. So the field goal unit is on the field, as this is a big spot right here. With 3 seconds to go, if it's good, we're off to overtime. And his kick is indeed good. And in the fourth quarter, this game is tied. Four quarters not enough. We're all even, and to overtime we go. And here in overtime, if the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we can still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game. If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving team throws a pick six or fumbles the ball and gets picked up by the defense and they score, the game is over at that point.
So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. And they will play it safe here and bring this one out to the 25. Carolina getting set to take the field.
They control their own destiny here. They have the football in overtime. Obviously, a touchdown would win it.
And I think teams around the league are still adjusting to the idea of going downfield. Scoring a touchdown wins the game because they were used to just going downfield and trying to get in field goal range to win. Game. Still having to make that transition. Let's face it now, the ones who are doing it best know they need to go down, attack, put the ball in the end zone, and not leave it up to a field goal and give the other team a chance.
As we said, they control their own destiny now. Eluding the pressure right. And he wisely will throw that one away. Another nice job there defensively. They've really stymied their passing attempts, and it continues in overtime.
And for them to do that, that means they've had to be cohesive on defense. Pressure in the quarterback's face, good coverage of not just the wide receivers, but the tight end, the running backs when they try and slip out, and making sure they're at the point of attack. When the ball's in the air, they get there and help force some of those incompletions.
Charles, you get into these overtime situations, that's not a bad guy to dial into.
Well, when you have to have plays, especially in a spot as you just described, we're in OT, you've got to go to the guys you can trust and you know are going to make the plays. Well, they say, it's not the X's and the O's, it's the Jimmies and the Joes.
He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. A big play there. Catch and run.
Well, that certainly changes things here because they're in field goal range already, but a field goal, that's not what they're looking for now, not after that big play right here in overtime.
Flush to his right. And this will be caught. Touchdown. They needed overtime to get it done, but put this one in the win column. So the game-winning touchdown came through the air in overtime. Four quarters wasn't enough. We were treated to a really good one, weren't we, Parker?
That we were, and I just love being able to be witness to a game like this all the way through. Who's going to win it? Oh, what? We're getting overtime? Great for us. A lot of tension on the field. Very tough. Not a surprise it ended with a passing touchdown. That's the way we play in the NFL. But the execution was pretty darn good.
Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you hold on to it. They got it done, and they feel very good about that victory.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaughton. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. The Panthers are winners here as we say so long from Charlotte.